personally, I'm pro rancor. I'm pro vitriol. I am pro someone doing something about this rather than being polite when you hear the President of the United States say the answer is to give every teacher in America a gun. That is insane. That is an insane idea. As Mark Barden, one of the fathers who lost a child in Sandy Hook, whose wife is a teacher. I mean, seriously, did anybody go to school here? Does anybody remember their teachers? Do you think we should give all of them guns? But, I mean, do you think they want guns? I mean, just what kind of country do we live in when we're talking about giving every teacher in America a gun?
But the
and
fact,
that's a solution to this problem?
But the fact that you had two people stand up as part of this dialogue and say, Mr. President, not the way Jeff just said it, but in a respectful, very clear way, really bad idea. The fact that they were able to do that, I think, is really noteworthy.
Sure.
Right?
That one of the great things about our country is that we do have freedom of speech, and I'm glad it was exercised in the White House. But for anybody to get their hopes up when we have an entire political party, I mean, look at the vote yesterday in the Florida House of Representatives. Mm-hmm. Every Republican voted against this bill to limit assault weapons. I mean, I think it's fabulous what these kids are doing. I think it's intensely admirable. But the idea that we are on a verge of some change. Anybody remember the Million Mom March? Similarly impressive. Nothing happened.
Sean, the president said, he wanted teachers potentially to have a concealed weapon, a gun, maybe 30%, whatever he said. And they would have to go through special training, and maybe they could hire, former military personnel to be involved as well. You spent 25 years in the Marine Corps.
Yeah, no, look, I think this is a monumentally bad idea. I mean, this is not to say not to disparage teachers in any way, but the truth is, throughout my military training, one of the things I learned is that speed matters. In these cases where we have people walk in with firearms, and if they're on a mission to open fire and to hurt people, yes, a teacher may at some point be able to get a gun and stop this, but that's not going to happen before we see people who have been killed or harmed. And I agree that this feels different, but I think that there has been a pressure that's been building in this country for a long time. I remember Sandy Hook like it was yesterday, and I'll tell you, if I ever thought that something was going to change in this country, it was after Sandy Hook.
Yeah, me too.
And so I think that we're at a moment where we know that something's going to change. And the question is if it's going to be these students right now who are going to make it happen, or if it's going to be the next shooting.
Or if it's going to be this president. Because with Barack Obama, there was always that political line, he wants to take away all your guns. He's anti-Second Amendment. Donald Trump, pro-Second Amendment. So maybe Donald Trump, and again, I don't want to be Pollyanna here, would have some more success in saying, okay, more stringent background checks, or, maybe raising the age limit. I mean, one of the students there was saying, I can't buy a beer. I shouldn't be able to buy this kind of a gun. Maybe that will change. Maybe it gets nibbled at around the edges. Donald Trump's not going to propose an assault weapons ban.
It's got to be somebody like Donald Trump who had the benefit of more than $30 million
from
the
NRA.
Exactly.
Let's see what, if anything, emerges. Truly extraordinary moment in American history right now. We'll see what happens.